All right, back in the studio. Take 397. I am ready, Justin. Where's the band? Is the band ready? Okay. Well, guess we can do this a cappella. I am a professional after all.
We're actually doing an interview today.
What?
We're doing an interview today.
We're doing an interview today?
We're in the wrong room.
Oh. Wanted to sing a song.
Hey everybody, I'm Justin over at Sound 81 Productions. Welcome to Behind the Glass. I'm here with Daisy Bouquet, and we're going to be talking about her record Pansy that was just done here at the studio. Thank you so much for being a part of this and for doing your record here and for being, you know.
Well, thank you. I had a great time here. This is the best. I'd never been in the recording studio before. It was my first album. So getting to do all of this audible art, as I like to call it, it was great to be able to do it here.
Well, and the session, you know, was just so positive, and you brought in a lot of different musicians and so many different styles. I mean, like, talk me through, like, what was kind of the vision of this album? What did you want to give the people?
Well, I knew that when I started planning this record about 2 years ago, I knew if it was going to be my first album, I wanted to make sure it sort of encapsulated everything that goes into one of my live shows, which is a little bit of something for everybody. And as I went through endless lists of songs and material, I knew that I finally landed on everything that I liked. And then my next favorite part was picking all the musicians. And I reached out to Victor and Penny, the Philistines, Molly Hammer, and they all shockingly said yes. So I was thrilled that they were able to help make this happen. And then, of course, being able to do it in this space where this studio can accommodate every style. And I loved the way you were able to, I mean, you just knew by hearing the song, you were like, all right, we're doing it like this, it's this, and it all came to life. Everybody I've talked to has really enjoyed it so far.
Well, I'm glad that you had that experience.
The experience to me was not unlike photo shoots, for example. All of the work is everything that happens before the shoot itself. Mm-hmm. And as long as you have all of that ready to go, then the actual moment where you're creating it, where you're taking the picture, recording the song, that to me should be the most enjoyable part. That's the easiest part. That's the payoff for all the work that goes into planning it and putting it together. And I thought everybody brought their A game. And I thought I was amazed by how much we were able to accomplish in the studio in really not a lot of time. You know, we were able to turn around all those songs pretty fast, but everybody came in ready to go.
Yeah.
And all the songs that I had been hearing in my head for the past 2 years, I was ready to sing them. So we put them all down pretty quickly, not just quickly, but expertly, professionally. You know, I'm a stage performer, so I'm used to going on stage every night and delivering the same caliber performance every single time. So, you know, if we did a song and had to do several takes, I was ready to do it full out each
sure.
time, which I think was very helpful in the final product.
What you said right there of being prepared, this is a perfect example mm-hmm. of coming in and all of us lining in, knowing what we do best and just trusting the parts of everybody. And it turned out to be a great experience.
Right. And, you know, I didn't get to work with most of these musicians until we were here. So, I mean, it was very nerve-wracking, you know, especially for my first time doing something this big of an undertaking. But, like I said, everybody was prepared. I was prepared. And it made for a very positive experience recording in the studio. And we were able to have fun and play around with things because of that.
Something that I thought was just incredible about doing this record is you are so defined with who you are. And being able to put this down as an artist, to be able to come into the studio dressed as Daisy, to come back as Spencer and to be able to own those parts is just incredibly inspiring to me.
Thank you.
Especially, you know, and I feel that this record really showed people who you are. It has humor. It has the passion, you know, like Pansy. It's a very emotional song. You know, when you first tracked that down, we brought in
Eric.
He did a beautiful job on the piano. And it was the first time I heard that song. We kind of tracked it and it was inspiring. And then going on with, you know, like brass balls and this, and it shows your kind of stage humor. I feel like you really nailed this. Not that you need my approval or anything, you know, but
well, that makes me happy.
It does. You know, the record really is just kind of like, this is Daisy, you know, and all the different pieces, but being able to put yourself out there and, you know, to go on stage, to drop this album, to have the diversity speaks to who you are as a person and as an artist.
Thank
and
you.
I really do.
Yeah,
that.
I mean, that. I mean, having you pointed out the two original songs,
yeah.
And those were not easy. I do have fun playing around with lyrics, but I wouldn't say it's my strong suit. So Balls of Brass, when we recorded it, I had all of those lyrics laid out months in advance. And it wasn't until the night before I came in to record that song that I was up till about 5 a.m. changing lyrics.
Really?
I looked at those and I went, that's not right. And I was up till 5 a.m. working on it, and I was thrilled. I then came in around 11 a.m. that day, and I was like, I hope this works. And it did, and I was very happy with it because I like to show this sort of multi-dimensional aspects of the character, of
sure.
my character. So Balls of Brass is really a hoot. And then Pansy was a big challenge. That was a big challenge to write. I knew what I wanted to come out of the song. I knew the message that I wanted to come out of the song, but I didn't want it to sound too schmaltzy. It's a little schmaltzy, but beautifully so. And I reached out to my friend Eric, brilliant, brilliant piano player. And I sang him the song. I sent him the lyrics. I said, do you think you could do the underscoring for this with piano? And we had a session over at his place. And it brought tears to my eyes. I was like, this is it. This is the song. So I was really happy with how it turned out. And I had a friend of mine who listened to the album, and he said, I feel bad for people who don't know you listening to this. And I was like, what do you mean? I was like, do you think they won't enjoy it? He goes, well, I just know you very well, and this is all you. And this, to me, it makes it more special that I know who you are. And I was like, God. All right.
Well, it's very true. You know, it's a huge responsibility as engineers when you work with people because you are capturing part of their moments in their career and moments in their life. To come with a record that had so much diversity, you know, that is unique. There's a lot of people that it's like, it's got to be this and it has to be this. And this is the image I'm coming out and this is what I want to be. You came at it and it shows in the work that, no, this is me. And this is what I'm going to do. You kind of approached it like, I need to show myself. And that really does come through in the diversity and styles of the album.
Thank you. Yeah. If you're putting something that out into the world that you want people to listen to and enjoy, and not just listen to once, like come back to and listen to it over and over, you have to take a lot of care and pride into what you are putting out there, you know, so...
Well,
I was happy
speaking
with that.
Of putting it out.
Putting it out.
Happen
putting
to
out.
Have a copy of it right here. Tell me about the packaging, because I really do love the packaging.
The packaging is stunning. We did the photos with Vixen Pinup Photography in the fall of 2016. That was when I decided I was doing an album.
Record.
And I said, if I can get this photo shoot done, that will kick this into high gear for me. And it still took a lot of time, but it was, I love working with Vixen Pinup Photography. And my friend Brandon, who I've known for a very long time, I approached him around the same time about doing the album design for it. And so he said yes, and I was thrilled. And you know, all of the people that worked on this got paid. That was the other very important thing to me. I was like, I might not see money back from this for a very long time. But that's not the important thing. I wanted to make sure that everybody that was included had a good time and also felt appreciated for their talent and work on this. And it was all Kansas City people, which made it, you know, also exceptionally special to me.
Sure.
Because as somebody who tours around the country, being able to take this product from show to show and for people that, you know, pick it up and look at the liner notes and everything, they go, wow, I guess I need to check out more of what Kansas City has to offer. Yeah. Or let me look up and see mm-hmm. more about the Philistines or Victor and Penny, mm-hmm. you know, because we all have such different tastes and styles, but we all have an appreciation of the work and the music that we put out there. You know, this is a way of sort of branching out and getting more people to know about us, I think.
Where does this album, or where are you taking this album, and what do you plan to do with it to push it farther?
Well, you know, right now it's very interesting because we're still very much in the sort of recently released process. Sure. And I have a bunch of gigs coming up with the other group that I tour with later this year. I have plans to put together a show that involves the musicians that worked on the album. But everybody's schedules are so sure. busy. That was one of the things that made it difficult to record this in the first place, having everybody in the same room to make it happen. But I was really inspired after my friend Amy, who produced it, who was in here a lot with us during the recording. She goes, so what are you thinking about for a second album? And I was like, girl, I just, give me a second. And I had a friend come up to me at the release party that said, I love your original songs. When are you doing an album of originals, of all originals? And I was like, those two songs, that was a lot already. But just to know that people are so excited about what I've already, what's already come out of this album and have latched on to the creative stuff that I've put into the album. It's reinvigorated me to want to create more. So I don't know. I feel like I have to start looking at that sooner than later.
I love it. It kind of opens up a whole new door and, mm-hmm. you know.
And I know I can do it here because you make it a very fun playground of creating music. So I love
that. It's Narnia.
It's Narnia in here.
Yes. So let's talk about where they can get this album.
They can buy it almost anywhere. I have physical copies available at any of my performances. Most of my in-town gigs happen to be at Missy B's in Midtown. They can also download the album directly from my website, digital download. If they do iTunes or Amazon, Spotify, I'm sure there are a couple of other streaming ones that I don't know. Google Play.
Mm-hmm.
I don't use half of them. I know them. I'm familiar with them. But whatever outlet is there, I try to make it accessible for everybody. So as long as you have something to listen to music with, you should be able to find it.
I love it.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for doing this interview and for being a part of our family here and for bringing your project. It really was inspiring, and I'm not doing that to, you know, I love when people are themselves, and it always comes through that way.
Oh, we had a good time.
We did have a good time.
We had some laughs.
We did have a lot of laughs. So, well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
I really do appreciate you being here, and we definitely want to back up the work, and we're so thankful that you did it here, and congratulations on your new release. Definitely check it out. You heard where to find it. We're going to post all the links at the end of this video. It's definitely something to check out, and it has a lot of different genres and varieties. So anyways, that is my story. My name is Justin.
I'm Daisy.
All right. Have an awesome day.
Let the pansies grow, let the pansies grow, let the pansies grow. Let the pansies grow, let
the pansies grow.